Now, Judy sent me a question about this, the Delta variant. With the Delta variant becoming the predominant variant in some states, what percentage of Oregon cases are this variant? So you are right, Delta, the dominant variant in the U.S., and also just becoming the most common variant in California. So it is spreading very quickly. Scientists say it's more contagious and possibly more severe of a strain of the virus for people who are unvaccinated. We checked with Oregon, and it's a much different story here. Believe it or not. To date, the state has only identified 14 cases of COVID caused by the Delta variant specifically, and it only makes up about 5% of all the variants circling in Oregon in recent weeks. But the health authority did tell us that they expect this to go up since that variant is spreading so quickly across the United States and very close to us. We already said California and in Washington, as of the end of June, they've identified 656 cases of the Delta variant. That made up about 28% of all variants circling in that state. So it is more prevalent in Washington than Oregon right now. But to be clear, if you are vaccinated, you're extremely safe from any of the variants of COVID. But if you're not vaccinated, you are as much in trouble from the Delta variant or any other strain of COVID-19, potentially more with the Delta one, but none of them are great to get. You got us? Right now, less than half of the population in the United States is fully vaccinated. That's why you're seeing headlines like this one, warning about a dangerous fall and the potential for mask mandates to come back because of the Delta variant. Since it's more contagious, health experts say it will really hit unvaccinated populations hard. It's expected to. And there's a lot of parts of the country, including in Oregon and Washington, where there are not a whole lot of people vaccinated. So again, the best way to protect yourself and your family and hopefully avoid more COVID restrictions is to get vaccinated.